Hi there. In this video, we'll take a detailed look into the admin dashboard of Rebuild the Chain Pandemic Management Platform. This dashboard is for health ministries, Department of Health, health authorities, and health workers, where they can access the various features and insights provided by the platform. So I'm going to be logging into the platform as a super administrator. Once I log into the platform, I am presented with a dashboard. This is a well-designed dashboard that factors in some of the key aspects and metrics which are relevant from a pandemic management perspective. The dashboard incorporates the metrics that are currently followed by ministries in Southeast Asia and Latin America. The dashboard shows an overview of the pandemic infection in the country. It shows information regarding the total number of patients, the primary contacts, the secondary contacts, and recovered patients as well. It also shows a gender-age distribution graph, which is quite useful in terms of understanding the infection into the community, the impact upon the senior population, etc. Here you can see the number of cases of infection distributed across a selected time frame. You can see the day-by-day statistics of new patients, primary contacts, secondary contacts, and recovered patients. The dashboard also emphasizes on the need to understand the source of infection over a period of time. Here on the right-hand side, you can see a graph which shows the source of infections, categorized into community transmission and imported cases. If it's an imported case, we try to identify the country from which that case was imported. The graph here shows the distribution of infection sources for the imported cases, and the graph here shows the distribution of infection based on gender. This information is acquired into the platform from the pre-screening process in citizen-side mobile application. You can also see the spread of cases, the daily confirmed cases, and the daily recovered cases. All the components you see in this dashboard are highly customizable. You can filter the data by time frame, by zone, by city, by zip code, etc. Based on the local authority's requirements, we can add extra components in the dashboard, such as the number of tests conducted and reports of COVID cases, etc. So these are quite interesting aspects which help the authorities get an overall picture or a holistic view of how this pandemic has played out in that particular region. From the Sub-Admins tab, you can create sub-admin accounts and manage the different access level controls for them. Using access control, you can determine who sees what information and what they can do on the platform. For example, you can create a sub-admin to manage the activities for a particular state or province. All of this is configurable when we deploy the platform for each government. The Users tab shows all the users added to the platform. You can filter the users by different categories, such as high risk, low risk, primary or secondary contacts, etc. This information is based on the health status or the threat score, which is identified as part of the pre-screening process. The primary and secondary contact information is automatically identified by the artificial intelligence system by performing automated contact tracing and exposure analysis of the citizens. For the concerned authorities, this list provides a detailed assessment of primary and secondary contacts that they need to contact and quarantine. You can also add users into the platform manually. Here, you can add the user details, places they visited, people they contacted, pre-screening responses, etc., to add a new user into the system. This is useful when a health worker or a doctor is diagnosing patients at a clinic, or if they want to add a walk-in patient into the system. When you click on a user, you can access a detailed report of the user. This report includes the user's basic details and analytics insights. From the GIS map view, you can backtrack by choosing two specific dates and see where the user has traveled between these specific dates. In addition to the map view, there is also a list view, which shows the specific time and location where the user was. So it's a timestamp-based route history which helps the health worker to analyze the exposure. In terms of human-to-human as well as human-to-surface transmission, and plan for disinfection and further remedial activities. On the left-hand side, you can see the category of the user, who is now categorized as a high-risk profile. This is based on the analysis of the pre-screening data, contact tracing, and exposure analysis of the user. There is also a case ID, which has been assigned for this particular user, and there is a probability score, which represents the probability of the user being infected. And there is a severity score, which indicates what is the severity of his current symptoms and whether it requires medical attention. So these scores are defined by a threshold, and these thresholds would trigger alerts within the dashboard for authorities to provide medical assistance or to monitor the situation more closely. Below, you can see the list of contacted persons of the users. This is automatically identified based on contact tracing. This particular list shows personally identifiable information. However, depending on the data privacy policies of the region, the platform can hide personally identifiable information in the dashboard. For demo purposes, this dashboard shows all information possible, but ideally what would happen is if the person has not authorized consent for personal identifiable information to be shared, the dashboard would just show random IDs. But these random IDs can be sent notifications through the platform. Although we may not identify the person, we can still send in a notification to them saying that they are now identified as a primary contact. This reach out can happen via an alert or a notification through the application or via an SMS sent out to them. Below, you can see a list of answers that have been revealed as part of the initial screening process. There are also daily screening questions as part of the daily check-in process. This information is very useful when we want to monitor the situation of patients or citizens who are currently in isolation at home or are currently in quarantine. This helps the health workers to monitor the conditions of these individuals remotely without having them check in physically into a hospital or a clinic. Also, there are some basic questions which are being asked to the citizens over three periods of time, which is morning, afternoon, and evening. You can see whether their conditions are improving or deteriorating. The Patients tab lists all the confirmed patients. Similar to the Users tab, you can access all the information of patients from the Patients tab. The next tab is the Hotspots tab, from where you can see the micro as well as macro hot zones in the region. Micro hot zones can be restaurants, shopping malls, etc., and macro hot zones can be specific places, a city square, etc. Authorities can see the hot zones data in real time and take necessary actions to lock down these places and initiate measures such as disinfecting, fumigating, etc. From this tab, authorities can add hot zones manually as well. You can define a location, add a radius for coverage, and pinpoint the location on the map to create a hot zone. When a hot zone is created, alerts are sent automatically to people within that radius to be confined into their homes, take early precautions, and not to enter the hot zone. The system also automatically identifies the probability of certain regions to become a hot zone in the coming days, based on the data that has been acquired. And with that information, the health authorities are able to create more hot zones and protect the community, foreseeing in the future. The Notifications tab is fairly self-explanatory. You can create notifications based on specific user types, whether it's a high risk, low risk, medium risk, etc. Or you can create a notification to be sent out to users in a specific location. And these notifications can be pushed immediately to the users or over a specific recurring time period, which could be every 1 hour, 2 hours, or every 5 hours. And we can also integrate with the local SMS providers, so push notifications or SMS alerts can also be sent out to users of feature phones as well. And this allows us to get them on board if they are a smartphone user, or just notify them immediately if they have been identified as a primary contact. The next tab is a helpline. This is basically an account management system for the helpline part of the citizen application. We can define the regions for which these helplines are applicable. So people will get the helpline numbers of the health facilities or health centers in and around their region, where they can immediately reach out to a health professional. We can integrate this with a telemedicine provider as well. From the Announcements tab, you can create official announcements that are shown on the Citizen Side mobile application. Authorities can send live news feeds and constant updates in terms of the progress of the situation to the community. And this is a way in which we can ensure that authentic information is being pushed to the community. The next tab is the visualization tab. This tab basically shows the spread of infections and the severity of infections across a state. In this case, we are looking at a state in India. We can layer this map with any sort of information that is relevant to the pandemic perspective. We can even show the spread of infection, show a timeline of how the infection has progressed or reduced with the containment measures. So, from a management perspective, if there is a zonal worker looking at a particular district or a state, we can show the map of the particular state and it allows them to monitor and see the progress or manage the zone more effectively, and we can see how the infection is spreading across that region as well. The Alerts tab is essentially a quarantine management system. From here, authorities can monitor people who are currently in quarantine and ensure they are not violating the terms of quarantine. The system constantly monitors their GPS, their mobile device, Wi-Fi, and Bluetooth proximity details. If any of their signals have switched off, the system is able to note that information, and admins get an instant alert on the screen as well. The system can immediately notify authorities if someone has moved from their quarantine zone or if there is a breach of their quarantine terms. One of the interesting features of the platform is the epidemic calculator. Here, the system shows the key parameters to actually monitor to determine how effectively you are flattening the curve. So, from the day zero of identifying the first case for a population of X value, we are able to see the number of cases that are susceptible to this disease, who have currently been infected, and who have currently been hospitalized. So, with that data, we are able to help the authorities to understand how soon they can flatten the curve with the pandemic management solution. This data can also be used for resource management, which is shown in the Resource Planning tab. Here, authorities can change the parameters of the pandemic spread to forecast the number of cases that could happen in the future. With this information, authorities can anticipate the resource requirements, such as the number of hospital beds needed, number of ventilators and doctors needed, etc. So, with that, we are wrapping up the demo of the government side application or the healthcare side application. Thanks for watching.